Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. Let's wait 2 minutes more. 42 students are here. 41 students are here actually, including me, it is 42. Roll number 1.
Yes, ma'am.
Roll number 2.
Present, ma'am.
Roll number 3.
Present, ma'am.
4.
Present, ma'am.
5. Roll number 5.
Present, ma'am.
Roll number 6.
Present, ma'am.
Roll number 7.
Present, ma'am.
Roll number 8.
Present, ma'am.
Roll number 9 is absent. 10.
Present, ma'am.
11.
Present, ma'am.
12.
Present, ma'am.
13.
Present, ma'am.
14. Roll number 14. Fifteen.
Present, ma'am.
16.
Present, ma'am.
17.
Present, ma'am.
18. Roll number 18. Roll number 18. Giving absence. 18 present.
Yes, ma'am. Roll number 18 is present.
Okay. 19.
Yes, ma'am. 20.
Present, ma'am.
21. Roll number 21. Roll number 21.
Present, ma'am.
22.
Yes, ma'am. Present.
Okay.
23. Present, ma'am.
24.
Present, ma'am.
25.
Present, ma'am.
26. 27.
Present, ma'am.
28.
Present, ma'am.
29.
Present, ma'am.
30.
Present, ma'am.
31.
Present, ma'am.
32.
Present, ma'am.
33. Roll number 33. For giving absent. 33. Then 34. Roll number 34. Roll number 34. 35.
Present ma'am.
36.
Present ma'am.
37.
Present ma'am.
38.
Present ma'am.
39.
Present ma'am.
40.
Present ma'am.
41.
Yes ma'am.
42.
Yes ma'am.
43. Roll number 43. 43.
Present ma'am.
44.
Yes ma'am.
45.
Yes ma'am.
So here what I'm getting, roll number 9, 14, 33 and 34 is absent.
Nine present.
Ma'am.
14 present.
14 present. So you came late. You have joined late.
Yes.
Don't be late from the next day. Otherwise, you will not get attendance. I'm saying again and again. Roll number 30. So two students are absent. Roll number 33 and roll number 34. Is it? So two students are absent, roll number 33 and roll number 34. So I will send this absent report to your department, IT head. So roll number 33 and 34. So all of you just fill up your Google form and don't depend on this roll numbers. That is, I'm calling your roll numbers and you are getting the attendance. That is not. So as I have to send this roll numbers to your department, so I'm taking the attendance now. But your written attendance, that is the original Google form that you have to send. So I'm telling again and again that whenever I have to give the marks, then I will only depend on the Google form attendance. And there I will check these roll numbers, because 33 and 34 will not fill up their attendance in Google form. So for the two reasons I'm taking this attendance. So first is for sending the attendance to your department, and second one is for my personal checking of your attendance with the Google form. The note was given to your WhatsApp group yesterday. And this is the remaining. Is anyone want to join? What is happening? I'm stopping my presentation. So roll number 33 and 34.
Yes ma'am.
So why are you 34. Late? It's 10:11. So why?
Sorry ma'am.
For the all students I am waiting, and actually you are wasting the time of your class, and it is hampering the study of your friends. So you are totally responsible for that. Roll number 33 and roll number 34. You are totally responsible for wasting the time of your class. And creating the problem for the whole students. Everyone is listening my words, what I am saying. If all the students join early, then I can start my class earlier and you will get much time. So all of you are present now? Now is the screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So what I'm thinking, I will check the attendance at last again. If you think you are that, if you are all thinking that giving the attendance then out of my out of the class, that is not possible for you. Geometric interpretation of grade 5. Now we consider two level surfaces S1 and S2. So these are the two level surfaces S1 and S2 in the scalar field, which are very close to each other. So S1 and S2 are the two surfaces and in the scalar field, which are very close to each other and characterized by the scalar functions phi and phi plus delta phi. So here this surface, here phi, here it is constant. And here phi plus delta phi equal to constant. So scalar function in S1 surface, it is phi. And in S2 surface, it is phi plus delta phi. I'm just interpreting the geometric interpretation of grad phi. So two level surfaces, S1 and S2. And the scalar constant here phi. And here it is phi plus delta phi. Now what I'm taking, let R and R plus delta R be the position vector of P in S1. So let's take one point here, P point in S1. In S1 surface, I'm taking one point P. And what is the position vector of this point? This is R. So this is R. This is the position vector of this point P. And I'm taking another point, that is Q, on the surface S2. And what is the position vector of this point? That is R plus delta R. And all this from this origin O. So position vector of this Q point, that is R plus delta R, this is from origin O. And also the position vector of this point P, that is R, this is also from origin O. This is also from origin O. So I'm considering all this thing with respect to the origin O. Then PQ. So what is P? Here the point is P and here the point is Q. So I am finding out what is PQ. So PQ. What is this? From O to Q. What is O to Q? What is OQ? Tell me. So PQ is what? PQ is OQ minus
OP.
OP. So PQ. I'm going to find out PQ. So PQ equal to what? OQ minus OP. Okay. So what is OQ?
R plus delta R.
Okay, so I have written R plus delta R. And minus is what? Minus OP. And what is OP?
R.
So PQ, this one is written as R plus delta R minus R. That is equal to what? That is equal to delta R. So PQ is actually delta R. In Cartesian, actually this proof you will not get in exam, but as gradient is in your syllabus, so you have to understand what is the geometric interpretation of grad phi. What type of problem you will get? Two problems I discussed last day. There's some scalar function will be given. You have to find out the gradient of that. So now just I'm explaining the geometric interpretation. that in Cartesian coordinate system, P and Q with respect to O. So, and x plus delta x, y plus delta y, z plus delta z, actually r plus delta r, r actually it is this, here it is x component, y component and z component. You know that is r vector, this is equal to xi hat plus yj hat plus zk hat. So, and delta r, if I write delta r, then if I take r as x, if there is only x component, no y and no z, then I can write this one as x plus delta x. If there is only y coordinate, then I can write this as y plus delta y, and I can write it as z plus delta z. So r plus delta r, this can be written as x plus delta x, y plus delta y and z plus delta z. So in Cartesian coordinate system, P and Q with respect to O. So what is the coordinate system in Cartesian coordinate system? I can also express the position of point P and position of point Q as what? P is what? This is R. So R means X, Y, Z. R means X, Y, Z. Three coordinates are here. Three components are here. So I have written, if I don't write in terms of R, if I want to write in Cartesian coordinate system in terms of X, Y, Z, then what will be the coordinate of X, P? This is what? What is the coordinate of P?
X, Y, Z.
X, Y, Z. And what is the coordinate of Q? X plus delta X.
X plus
delta Y plus Z.
Z plus delta Z.
So this is written like this. So coordinate of P and Q in Cartesian coordinate system, it is written like this. Now I already said, so this figure is again given here for easier understanding. Now delta R, actually R is what? X I hat X plus J hat Y plus K hat Z. Now delta R is what? Delta R equal to what? I hat delta X plus J hat delta Y plus K hat delta Z. As I have taken delta sign here, so I am taking delta sign in right hand side also. So delta R equal to this. Now, what is grad phi? So if I, no, sorry, not grad phi here, it is delta. Actually, it is the symbol is just the opposite symbol. This is delta phi. So delta phi, that it can be represented as del phi by del X into delta X plus del phi by del y into delta y plus del phi by del z into delta z. So this is del phi. Actually here in this surface phi equal to constant, and here it is phi plus delta phi equal to constant. Now what is delta phi? This is delta or del phi or delta phi. This is written as del phi by del x into delta x, del phi by del y into delta y, del phi by del z into delta z. Now see, I'm just writing the expression in this way. That means this dot means you know. So if I calculate this dot this, I will get this symbol, this line. Why? See, here it is I hat. Here it is I hat. So I hat dot I hat, what is the value?
One.
Okay.
Minus one.
So, I hat dot I hat?
One, ma'am.
One. J hat dot J hat one, K hat dot K hat one. So here it is I hat and here it is I hat. So I hat dot I hat is one. So what is remaining? Del phi by del x into?
Delta
x. And when you are multiplying this one with the others, then what is happening? Here it is I hat. And here it is J hat. I hat dot J hat. What is the value?
Zero.
So whenever I'm considering the first term and only considering the first term here, I'm getting the value. But when multiplying this one with the rest two, we are getting zero value. So in this way, for the rest, same condition. So I hat dot I hat is one. So del phi by del x into delta x. Now for the second term, J dot J, one. So del phi by del y into what? Delta y? del phi by del y into delta y plus plus is what? This term and this term. What is the value? This term and this term.
Del phi by del z into delta z.
Del phi by del z into delta z. So written here. So delta phi, that is, this is the expression. Now this expression I can write in this form. Same thing. This is equal to this. Now the first one, what is the value? I had del phi by del x plus j had del phi by del y plus k had del phi by del z that I discussed yesterday. This is grad phi. This is what? Grad phi. See. So the first term here, it is grad phi. And what is the second term? Is it this term? I had delta x plus j had delta y plus k had delta z.
Delta r.
So delta r.
Delta r.
Grad phi dot delta r. Okay. So delta phi equal to what? Grad phi dot delta r. So this is proved here, this expression. So it may be given in MCQ also. So this expression, what is the value? So you can express it in this way. Remember this one. Now, if we consider that the point Q, so this point Q lies on the level surface S1, then delta phi zero. See, what, where is the point Q lying? Q is lying on level surface S2 actually. Okay. Q is here, you can see in surface S2. Now, if Q is in the surface S1, Q S1 mein ho, mano Q abhi S2 mein nahi hai. It is on S1. Then what is delta phi? Q abhi idhar. It is on the surface S1. So P and Q both are on S1. So here in this surface, what is constant? Phi. And no delta phi is here in the surface. No delta phi is here. Delta phi is zero. Dekho. Phi equal to constant either. So delta phi, there is no delta phi here in the surface. So if that point Q comes to this surface, then will there exist any delta phi?
No, ma'am.
No. So delta phi equal to what? Zero. So if we consider that the point Q lies on the level surface S1, that means if Q is on the surface S1, then the value of delta phi, it is zero, because in the surface phi, only phi exists, no delta phi. So delta phi equal to zero. So if delta phi equal to zero, then what I can write? Grad phi dot delta r equal to what? Grad phi dot delta r equal to what?
Zero.
We have proved that grad phi dot delta r equal to delta phi. Now, if this one is equal to zero, so this grad phi dot delta r equal to what? Zero. So grad phi dot delta r equal to zero. So this shows that grad phi is normal to the level surface S1. What is the proof? Grad phi is normal to the level surface S1. So though if two vectors are there, their dot product is zero. That means what? Two vectors are
perpendicular.
So what that is given? Grad phi dot delta r equal to zero. We are getting. This shows that grad phi is normal to the level surface S1. So this is the physical interpretation. Grad phi, what is grad phi? Grad phi is normal to the surface. Okay. So if you take the grad of phi, you will get normal to the level surface S1. Now, if n hat be a unit vector along the normal to the level surface S1, so I'm taking that n hat be the unit vector along the normal to the level surface S1. To the level surface S1, the normal is, I'm taking the unit vector along this direction, that is n hat. Now, I can represent grad phi as grad phi equal to mod of grad phi into n hat. Then this you will satisfy this one. So grad phi equal to then mod of grad phi into n hat. N hat is what? Unit vector along the normal to the level surface is one. So here what you will remember, two expression you will remember always, that is delta phi equal to grad phi dot dr delta r. You will remember this expression, it may be given in MCQ. Second thing is what? That is grad phi. What is the physical interpretation, physical significance? Grad phi is normal because delta grad phi dot delta r equal to zero. This shows that grad phi is normal to the level surface S1. Grad means the normal. And now if I am taking the n hat is a unit vector along the normal to the level surface S1, then grad phi equal to this. Now next, if the perpendicular distance Rm, so what is R? This is R point. R is on the surface S1. And what is M? It is on the surface S2. So Rm. So if the perpendicular distance Rm between the two surfaces, so a perpendicular distance between the two surfaces, that means what? Between S1 and S2, through P and Q, B, delta N. If the perpendicular distance, perpendicular, so P point is here, Q point is here. So two surfaces are here and between the two surfaces, I am taking the perpendicular distance. The two surfaces are here, S1 and S2. Here what I am taking, the perpendicular distance between the two surfaces, that is R and M. Through PQ be delta N. Through P and Q, if it is delta N, then delta N, P and Q be delta N, then the rate of change of phi normal to the surface is d phi by dn. So perpendicular distance between P and Q, if it is delta n, if it is delta n, then the rate of change of phi, what is this? This is d phi by dn. Actually P here, it is Q here. The distance is not the perpendicular distance here between the two points. Now, if between these two points, what is the perpendicular distance? The perpendicular distance is Rm. Perpendicular distance is Rm. And that I am taking as delta n. That I am taking as delta n. Then the rate of change of phi. So phi, how it will change? D phi by dn. So delta, that means D, the same thing I have written here. So same type of meaning. So D phi by dn, this is the rate of change of phi. Because here it is phi and here it is phi plus delta phi. So what will be the rate of change of phi? So this is D phi by dn, where dn or delta n, same thing here, dn or delta n, that is the change. So the rate of change of phi is D phi by dn. Now, d phi by dn, that is equal to, that I can write, limit delta n tends to 0, delta phi by delta n, d phi by dn. So, phi is here. Here, the phi value is different. Here, total phi value is phi plus delta phi. So, phi has changed. Phi has different values in S2 surface. So, what is the rate of change of that phi? That I am finding out. The rate of change of phi equal to d phi by dn, where dn or delta n, what is this? The perpendicular distance between P and Q. The perpendicular distance between P and Q, this is R and M. So you see, this is the perpendicular. So Rm is the perpendicular distance between P and Q. And that I am taking as delta n. Delta n or dn. So phi is changing with this. Phi is changing with this distance. Because here phi, you can see phi has different value. So the rate of change of phi with n, that means this distance, perpendicular distance, d phi by dn, that I can write is limit delta n tends to 0, delta phi by delta n. Now, here in this place, what I have done, see, delta phi is what? The value, this I have proved earlier. What is the value of delta phi? What is the value of delta phi?
Grad phi into delta.
Delta phi dot. Delta phi equal to grad phi dot.
Delta r.
Delta r. So I have they proved this thing. Delta phi equal to grad phi dot delta r. I have proved. So I'm just putting the value here. Now I can write it as limit delta n tends to zero. Then here n hat dot delta r by delta n. So grad phi is again what? Grad phi I have written. Grad phi is what? Mod of grad phi into n hat. So grad phi equal to mod of grad phi into n hat. That I have written. Grad phi. This value. What I have written? Say grad phi equal to what?
Mod of grad phi.
Mod of grad phi into n hat. Okay. Now this mod value I have written in front portion. So this remains mod of grad phi limit delta n tends to zero n hat dot delta r by delta n. So I'm again explaining d phi by dn equal to, we can write mathematically as limit delta n tends to zero delta phi by delta n. Then replacing the value of this delta phi equal to what? Grad phi dot delta r, that value. This it is just substituted this value. Then what again I am doing? I'm substituting this value again. Grad phi. Grad phi is what? Mod of grad phi into n hat. So that value I have written. So it is kept here. And inside the limit, I have written limit delta n tends to zero n hat dot delta r by delta n. Now that thing. So grad phi as it is. So limit delta n tends to zero. It is now. This is delta n by delta n. I have written as what? N hat dot delta r. So this n hat dot delta r equal to what? Mod of delta r cos theta. And this is equal to delta n. So n hat dot delta r, this is again delta n. So delta n, so in place this place, n hat dot delta r, what I have written? Delta n. So delta n is written. So what is remaining? So only this equal to mod of grad phi into limit delta n tends to zero delta n by delta n. Now here only remaining this portion, that is equal to what? Mod of grad phi. So d phi by dn, what I have, it is mod of grad phi. Hence the magnitude of grad phi is d phi by dn. See, so grad phi, what is this? Grad phi. And what is this side? The magnitude of grad phi. Understand? So this is grad phi. What is this sign? This is the magnitude of grad phi is equal to what? Magnitude of grad phi is equal to what? D phi by dn. So what is this? Hence, the magnitude of grad phi is d phi by dn. So grad phi equal to d phi by dn into n hat is the greatest rate of change of phi with respect to the space variables. And grad phi may be defined as follows. The gradient of a scalar function phi is a vector whose magnitude is equal to the maximum rate of change of phi. So this is the physical significance of gradient. So gradient of a scalar function phi is a vector whose magnitude is equal to the maximum rate of change of phi. It's a d phi by dn. This is the change of phi. So this is the change of phi. So the gradient of a scalar function phi is a vector whose magnitude is equal to the maximum rate of change of phi with respect to the space variables and whose direction is along to that change. So n hat is there, unit vector along the direction. So grad phi, we can write it as grad phi equal to d phi by dn into n hat. So this is the physical significance of grad phi. So it can be written like this. grad phi, this is also d phi by dn. So rate of change of phi, this is the magnitude of grad phi equal to d phi by dn that I have written here. This is the greatest rate of change of phi. This is the grad phi. So this is the physical significance. And also the grad phi is normal to the level surface S1. कोई भी surface हो उसके ऊपर grad, if you take the grad, if you take the grad phi, this will be normal to the surface. If it is find out the normal to the surface, then you have to find out the gradient of this. So this is the physical interpretation. Now this problem I discussed yesterday, is it? Students, can you listen?
Yes, ma'am.
So these two problems I have discussed. Now see, electric potential and electric field. So electric potential, V equal to what? K Coulomb constant into Q by R. I think you all know this. Is it?
Yes.
Electric potential V equal to Coulomb constant into Q by R. V is the electric potential, K is the Coulomb constant, Q is the charge, and R is the distance of separation. Okay, so this is the form of the potential. Now, electric field. Electric field is what? 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R square into R hat. It is written in terms of vector. Okay, electric field. So electric field is this. Now, actually unit vector. Unit vector, how it is represented? R hat. R hat equal to vector R by mod R. Do you know this? Unit vector.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Unit vector, R hat equal to what? R hat equal to vector R. R hat equal to vector R by what? Mod R.
By mod of R.
Mod R.
Mod R. Actually, here in the denominator, what is R is written, this is mod value. Okay. So R square is written here, so this is the mod value. So in place of vector R, what I have written? Unit vector R, R hat, I have written what? Vector R by R. So here another R you will get in denominator. So R square is already there, and denominator you are getting another R. So it is what? R cube. Okay. So electric field that I can write 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q R vector R by R cube. Now, I can write it as E equal to minus grad V. How you can write it? See, what is here? Actually, R by R cube, vector R by R cube. Are you getting this? These are all constants values. So no problem with this. So what is the vector per part here? In electric field, R by R cube, this part, it is related. So this is R by R cube is important. So if you take this one vector, so if you take vector E equal to R by R cube, then if you are taking the gradient of E equal to what? So here R by R cube, I'm coming to the previous problem here. What you are getting? R by R cube you are getting here in this expression. And this problem you are getting R by R cube. So grad phi. So if you take the grad of phi, then you are getting R by R cube. And here the same term. See. Grad of 1 by R, is it? What is the problem? Grad of 1 by R equal to minus R by R cube. Okay, I have proved this. Try to understand what I am saying. Grad of 1 by R equal to what? Minus R by R cube. That I have proved. Okay?
Yes, sir.
I have proved this. Now, if I take grad of V, see, if I take grad of V, so on which I will calculate grad? 1 by R? So K and Q I will not consider here. Only I will take, if I take grad of V, K and Q will be with this. But no change in these two quantities. Only I will take the gradient. If I want to calculate grad V, then I have to take grad of 1 by R. Okay? And now what I have proved? Grad of 1 by R equal to what? R by R cube? Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
So grad of 1 by R equal to R by R cube. Try to understand what I am saying. So V in V mein kya hai dekho? V mein hai 1 by R hai. ठीक है तो v के ऊपर grad लिया जाए तो क्या होगा if I take grad on v then I have to take grad on 1 by r okay and what is the answer of grad of 1 by r answer is r by r cube okay so if I this so can I write this expression here that e equal to minus grad v see in the electric field In the electric field, I am getting this expression. I am getting this expression. This is the expression of electric field. Now, if I take the grad of V, I am getting minus R by R cube. So here it is no minus sign. So I have written here minus and I have written the grad of this, grad of V. Because you are getting grad of 1 by R, you are getting R by R cube. So from this expression, I can write that E equal to minus grad V. This is very important. And that I can prove from vector. That is the gradient operator is an important and useful tool in electromagnetic theory. The gradient of a scalar field is a vector that points in the direction in which field is most rapidly increasing with the scalar part equal to the rate of change. A particular application of gradient is that it relates the electric field intensity to the electric potential field. So electric field intensity to the electric potential field. So electric field intensity is E and this is the electric potential. So electric field intensity is E and V is the electric potential. So grad gives the relation between electric field intensity and electric field potential. Remember this one. Okay, so E equal to minus grad V. This is the proof here. It is proof from the vector that it is given in exam. That prove electric field equal to minus grad of V. This is very important. I mean, you also know earlier that this expression is true. So it is proved from this vector portion. That is, we know the expression of the electric field already this thing. And in this place, R by R cube. That I have written what R by R cube. If you take grad of V, then you will get this expression. So in this place, I have written grad V. So K is the Coulomb constant. So this is the part of the Coulomb constant. So this is the part of the K into Q. This is K into Q. It is as it is. Here also it is. It is 1 by R and here it is R by R cube. So I can write it as E equal to K into Q. Into R by R cube. So K and Q is here and also here. So what is the extra thing? 1 by R becomes vector R by R cube. And how it becomes? If I take grad V, then it will change to this one. So E equal to minus grad V. Is it clear for you, all the students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So this is the proof. That means if it is given electric field equal to minus grad V, you can prove it in this way. So a particular application of gradient is that it relates the electric field intensity to the electric field potential. Also, it may be given in MCQ, this type of problem. That what is the relation between this? Many answers may be given E equal to plus grad V, E equal to grad square V in this way. So you will must remember this expression. Now this problem. Have you done this problem? It was given in note. Same thing. Grad of r to the power n. Grad means what? I had del del x plus j had del del y plus k had del del z into r to the power n. R is what? Root over this whole to the power n. So no, nothing to be worried here because only you have to differentiate. So differentiation, only differentiation. And last, in place of this, x I hat, y j hat plus z k hat, I have given the value r vector. So you will, have you done this? Anyone, or you have, if you have not done, just take pen and paper and just calculate yourself and just check after that. Don't copy. And I said, everyone, to do it, whatever I am giving in notes, just calculate it in your own and in your own copy, physics copy. And don't copy it, because this is totally mathematics. If you copy it, you will not understand anything. So you have to just calculate. So grad of r to the power n, you have to calculate. The answer is n into r to the power n minus 2 into vector r. So don't copy it, just do it yourself in your physics copy. Now, another last problem here. You find the angle between the surfaces this and this at the point this. So you have to, two surfaces are there, and you have to find out the angle. Now, the angle between the surfaces at the point is the angle between the normals to the surfaces. So a normal, actually, what is a normal? If you take grad phi, so phi is this. So if you take grad phi is normal to the surfaces. Yes or no? If you have one surface, if you are taking the gradient of phi, what will be? Just I have said though, that is the physical interpretation of grad phi. That will be normal to the surface. Just tell me. Students? Hello? Tell me, is it true or false?
Ma'am,
phi is here. Phi is here. Phi 1. Say two surfaces are here. It is phi 1, this is phi 2. Two surfaces are here. So in phi 1, if you calculate grad phi 1, then you will get normal to the surface. Normal to the surface. So grad phi 1. So grad of this. Okay. So grad of this. So it is calculated here. And the point is given. 2 minus 1, 2. So grad phi at the point 2 minus 1, 2. It is given. Grad phi 1. So this is normal to the surface. This, it is grad phi 1. And again, this surface, normal to the surface. This, phi 2, this is. So grad phi 2. In the point, same point is given. So these are the two, grad phi and grad phi 1 and grad phi 2 we have. Now what I can write? Grad phi 1, take the dot product between the two. So dot product between these two, between the vectors. What is the dot product between A and B? A, if A and B are the two vectors, then dot product of A and B, what is the value?
AB cos theta.
That is mod A, mod B cos theta. So same here. Grad phi 1 dot here I want to say, as this is taken from book, so I know vector sign is here, but when you will write it in your copy, just you can't write in this way keeping the bold sign. So you will take one vector, so grad phi 1 whenever you will copy. So grad phi 1 dot grad phi 2, so just this symbol nabla vector. So grad phi 1 dot grad phi 2 equal to mod of this into cos theta, where theta is the required angle. So already you have calculated grad phi 1 and grad phi 2. So this is the take the dot product of this, the mod value of this 2 and cos theta. So from here, cos theta you are calculating. And this is our question. Find the angle between the two surfaces, this and this, at the point this. Okay. So for this, two surfaces are there. For each surface, you are all calculating the gradient. Now the gradient, grad phi 1 and grad phi 2 you are getting. Take the dot product of these two and you will get the value of cos theta. Another thing was given probably. Is it? No. Electric field and potential. Okay. So these are the problems here in this lecture, and nothing left. So the books, actually you can follow, it is given. Spatial vector analysis, this is a very good book. For ebooks, you told me that ebooks you have this book, Spatial vector analysis?
No ma'am.
So this is very good book, yeah, for your vector or this part, vector analysis. So okay, no problem. Whatever problems I am discussing, I will give assignments also, so you can solve it yourself. So this these questions, answers, these problems actually are taken from Spatial, that book, vector analysis. The problems that I have discussed, these all problems. So when I will give the assignment, you will just complete it yourself and you know how to solve. So from this, you may get find out the grad of phi. Phi will be given. You have to just calculate grad phi. So differentiation only you have to know. Just follow the procedure. How to solve the grad phi. Only put I hat del del x plus j hat del del y plus k hat del del z. You will get the answer. So mathematically in this way you can get. And what is the physical significance of grad phi? That may be given in MCQ. That what is this is grad. This is the significance of this. J grad phi is normal to the surface or lying on the surface. In this way, different type of options may be given, but you have to choose the correct answer. So actually, what I have discussed this thing elaborately. This proof you will not get. That you have to prove it. No. But this you have to know because you have to know what is grad phi. So this is gradient that I have discussed. And in my next class, what I will discuss divergence and curl. Actually, I said here, see, that this vector operator, vector differential operator del, this is vector differential operator del. With this, we can express what? Gradient, divergence, and curl. So, gradient I have discussed. The divergence and curl, yet I have to be discussed. So, tomorrow I will discuss divergence. What is the divergence of a vector? So, just calculate these problems yourself. And this is very important, this thing, E equal to minus grad V. This is also a very important problem. And I will give you the assignment tomorrow, today. Just check the Google Classroom. So this book is very, very good. Vector analysis by Moores Pigel. If you can buy this book yourself online or anything, then that will help a lot. Or otherwise, I will supply the problems. I will give the problems of that book and how to calculate I have given. So you can also calculate yourself. Okay, so I'm just ending my class here because time is over already.
Thank you, ma'am.
So I am just saying to every student, be punctual and join my class. Join my class. What is the time given for that class? Join in that time and don't delay. Otherwise, your time will be wasting and you will all have problem later.